A, I would have looked more into the facts of the case. B, I think the entire case wherein Kanhaiya Kumar, the leader of the chain message Jawaharlal University Students Union, was arrested, was actually based on some videos given by a news channel, which was later found to be doctored. Some of the videos were found to be doctored by the National Forensic Laboratory. So I think, A, the way the entire case was based on the evidence was not proper, A.
How would you, as an HRD minister, handle this? These are facts, you have placed that.
Yeah.
Was there a better method of handling it?
Yes, sir. So I think some statements were made wherein the entire university was being, its image was being tarnished. So I would say that if I would have been holding that position, I would have come out like this, that such cases should not be used to generalize the entire university. Facts of the matter should be looked into, and if found guilty, so there should be a proper course of action.
Whose contribution is more towards society? Doctor, engineer, or a primary school teacher? Yes. Whose contribution to the society is maximum? A doctor, engineers, or a primary school teacher?
Doctor, engineer, and primary
teacher.
Sir, I think all the three.
No, you have to pick one.
Advanced ranking, sir?
You have to pick the best. Like, give me the first one. That's it. Yeah. Can I go with the can I go with the next question?
Okay, I can just answer this.
Yeah.
I think it's a primary teacher.
Okay. Why?
Primary teacher is very important, sir, because primary schooling is one area where the basic foundation of a child is being moved. So I think that's very important to me. Second is doctor, because of the crunch in the number of doctors that our country is facing, and little choice of what kind of our medical fraternity. So I think the contribution of doctor is also important. But in contribution of engineers are also very important in taking the country to the next level of growth. But I would not say that engineers contribute less in comparison to doctors.
Right. The number of diverses is on the rise in Indian society. Diverse cases. So what could be the reason behind it?
Sir, I think number of divorce cases in the Indian society are on the rise because A, females have started to be more assertive. Because till now they were extremely submissive in the society and in the family. So there were a number of cases when, despite not being happy, they were still carrying the birth. They were still into that marital association. So I think one of the reasons is that females are becoming more assertive in terms of asserting their choices. Mm-hmm. Second, economic independence and interdependence or independence of women is also playing a big role in helping them take such a step, because now they are independent to take took care of themselves. Third, law is also supporting females in a sense, not increasing the number of cases of divorce, but I think in making them independent.
What do you say, you know, that scenario with respect to your own? You are from Haryana?
Yes, sir.
Would you visualize some, you know, thing which is, you know, what my colleague has asked? How do you visualize the divorce, you know, situation in Haryana? You generalize this in statements or some specific social milieu there.
Yeah, so I'll just clarify my point. It was not a generalized statement, because when I was saying that females are more free to assert their choices, I was basically talking about the areas where women are more independent. They would actually step out into the walls of the house and are contributing in the economic sphere. They're part of the skilled workforce.
How do you visualize the status of men in Haryana?
So status of women in Haryana, there are a number of facets to it. So first basis is if you earn the generation, it is lower than the national average because of some reasons. So yes, there are certain policies, there are certain areas that we need to work on, and that
which
is female design, which is one area. Second is the omnicable. So third is these are the main areas.
How do you start that? This is in Haryana, as you asked. You said female fetuside is one of the both are against the woman. So what should be the starting point to correct it?
So starting point to correct it is imparting education to women. So I personally support the reservation of women in legislative assemblies and parliament, because that will actually instill confidence in women.
Do we have reservation in parliament?
So we don't have a reservation for women in parliament.
Do we have it in local government?
Yes, sir.
How much? Do we have a reservation for graduates in local government?
The second house is the present. So I think 1/6 of seats are elected by the graduates.
If you ask local selection.
Yeah, local selection.
But what you are saying is not in local selection.
I'm sorry.
Right. Given a choice, would you say let us eliminate car panchayats from northern belt? They are not at all doing any good thing, right? Why should we have car panchayat? You have session court, high court, tribunals, everything. So I don't see any need for car panchayat. Can we pass an act and saying that let us not have no more car panchayat? No, what will you support?
So I will not support elimination of CAF, because CAF is a very old institution. It is some 500 years old institution which actually enjoys a lot of support among the agrarian belt of Haryana, Rajasthan, UP. And CAF has some good facets to it in terms of some disaster, in terms of actually imposing, imparting solidarity in the society. It is playing a big role.
Solidarity? Is second